off the music while that intro was playing, but hopefully it doesn't matter too much. You can hear two sounds once. Anyway, I'm talking like this because, well, I guess I'm jumping straight into Fahima. I'm a, you can't really tell right now, but I'm a fire genasi wizard, conjuration, and we'll be talking more about our characters later, but my best friend's name is Persephone, who's not here right now, but that's played by Elena.
Mm-hmm.
And this is
Adina. A-D-I-N-A, not I-D-I-N-A.
Ah.
Not to be confused.
So not like that one wizard.
No.
With the green skin.
And the icy hands.
Is she an earth genasi then? Or maybe a water genasi?
What would ice be? Ice would be water, I guess. But then water melts her. I don't know what she would be.
I'm just thinking the green skin. Well, anywho, what kind of wizard are you?
Illusion.
Illusion? Oh, I like illusions. They're a bit tricky.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can't see them.
Mm-mm.
I work with them. Real things, you know, like I conjure maybe this glass of water or something. It's nice. At third level, I can conjure whatever I want, just as long as it's smaller than a 5-foot cube.
Whatever you want?
Whatever I want.
It's impressive.
I know. And another great feature is if you choose the feat, that one, I can't remember what it is, but where you can remember anything. So, you can have a lock for something, and then you can memorize it, and then you can destroy the key, and then I can conjure it whenever I want from memory. And
right.
Then you have no way of getting in, except for me.
That's pretty cool.
D&D hacks. I didn't come up with it, I read it on the internet. I mean in a magic book.
In a magic wide web book.
Anyway, hello to all of our viewers. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I'm going to switch over to our view here. If you could, please let us know if you can't hear us, if the music is too loud, etc., etc. And Lexi, what are we cooking?
We are going to do a fish wish dish.
Yay!
I can't stop saying it that way, because fish wish dish.
Fish wish dish.
And then we're going to make some prismatic veggies and
Cone of cold.
Yes, that was all you.
Yay!
Actually, all of the things that you were like, here's what wizards do. Make something around this. And I was like, all right, sweet.
Hello, DC Lasser. Hello, Prometheus. Hello. So Wish is one of the highest level spells you can cast in Dungeons & Dragons.
Mm-hmm.
And it also is, not too arguably, the most powerful spell in D&D 5th edition. With Wish, you can basically cast it and wish for
anything
you want. Anything. I'll be honest, I can't get over Lex's amazing hair right now, Prometheus.
Oh, yeah? Just swooping it on back like that? Well, thanks.
And the problem with Wish, however, is that you can't get too greedy. Every time you ask for something that the DM deems too much.
Too greedy.
Actually, no.
Hmm.
I think it's... So, you can use Wish in two ways. One of the ways is to cast any spell of lower level. Any spell you want. And that has no restrictions on it. The second way is to make a wish. And every time you make a wish, whether it's, I want 50,000 gold, or I want a castle in my name, or I want to... become a dragon, whatever it is.
I want to become a dragon.
You have a 30% chance that you can never use Wish again.
What?
And that's how it is mitigated, so it's not super, super powerful. Prismatic Veggies is Prismatic Orb.
Or Prismatic Ball.
Or, yes, there's a couple of prismatic
all the prismatics.
Cells. And we have the Cone of Cold Martini, which is a... pretty powerful spell. I think it's 5th level, and it deals 8d8 damage, or half, on a saved constitution roll. So it's pretty powerful.
Ooh.
Do you want to tell them what you got?
So we used a little magic, and we're making a little cocktail, but we're using luster dust to give it a nice magical effect. So I've been soaking blueberries in vanilla vodka for like 4 hours.
Wow.
So that's what's in here. I'm gonna add a little bit more.
Let's see if we can, I wanna show them this.
Listeriousness,
yes. Let's switch over to the food cam. Let's get the food cam.
Boom. Oh man, that's cool.
Let's see. Oh yeah. Wow. Okay. Wow.
Boom.
Yeah.
Magic.
That's so magical. I'm gonna stick the camera right in there.
I know, it looks so cool.
Alright. That's so magical. I love it. I love it. Maybe we should make one of the drinks that kind of stays to the side so we can get a good photo of it later.
Yes, that is my plan. One I should put the luster dust.
Sparkly! Those blueberries are irrefutably alcoholic now, that is true.
Mm-hmm.
But what if your wish is to always be able to use wish?
I wish for 3 more wishes.
I don't think you can do that, but who knows? Also, we'll have to ask Mike Merles.
Like, don't be that guy.
Seriously. You know, the DM's gonna be like, no. Your wand backfires on you.
You can never use wish again. That's what I would do. I would be like, don't be that guy.
Prometheus, Lex, be honest with us. Are you an actual wizard?
Always. I have all the of the magical powers.
We'll see what this wish dish
boom
looks like. Ah! Yeah.
So we're gonna.
That's the picture glass. Ooh, cone. She made cone ice cubes.
So the way that I did it is we have these fun magical, square. Ice cubes that are for like whiskey rocks glasses, and I put limeade in them actually.
Oh, interesting.
So there's blue raspberry, which is in the drink mix. It's the Kool-Aid. No magic down there. And then vodka with the blueberries, which so you have blueberry, vanilla, blue raspberry, and then lime going into the drink. So.
Nice!
Which, the fish wish dish is gonna be basically like an ahi tuna steak, so it'll, the citrus should pair really well.
So excited!
So yeah, so you take this square cube, and I just put tinfoil in there, and boom!
Nice!
Yep.
That came apart really easily.
Yeah.
I feel like I can almost hear the limeade in it, because it's kind of like...
Yep, yeah.
Instead of like a hard crack. Yeah, it's like sugary.
Mm-hmm. And like another trash.
So is your drink gonna go in here?
We're just gonna put one in there for now. I kinda wanna put it back in the freezer just so the glass stays pretty.
Yeah, because I want, when I take a picture of this, I want it to be like nice lighting and everything.
For picture reasons, I'm not actually gonna drink out of that one. I'll drink out of this.
Follow us on Instagram at damselsindishes.com. That's our website. But also go to our website. Follow us at Damsels and Dishes, and you can see the final beautiful photo that we will take of this food, because it's a little hard to see on the webcam. But Lexi always walks you through how to make it. Thank you, Prometheus!
And so, like all martinis that have like olives in the bottom, instead we're using those blueberries that we soaked in vodka.
Look at that! I'm gonna food cam you.
Sweet.
So, we've got...
Boop! Bloobs. Bloobs are hanging out down there.
We got bloobs.
And
we
then,
got a cone.
So I dropped in, you're gonna wanna make a lot of the lime cubes, because normally to chill a drink you put regular ice cubes in, but you don't wanna change the flavor. So that's what we've got going on here, that I get to keep shaking with the fun shaker.
Are you gonna pour it in that glass?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna keep the cam right here then.
Ooh, it's really cold.
I'm getting better at this whole camera operating thing.
I'm getting worse at pulling this apart. We're good. Magic!
Here she goes! Ooh, yeah. Oh, and the candle's illuminating it. Yes.
So it's got that fun lustrousness.
Oh, yeah. More purple than it appears. Oh my gosh. It's so sparkly. Guys, that's sparkle. That is sparkle.
Boom.
It's so much more blue on the camera, but it's very purple in real life.
Yeah.
I can try to like, yeah, you can't really tell. Wow. Push the ice cube in again. Oh my god, it's so sparkly!
Yeah.
I love it!
I don't know why we don't use luster dust in everything. And we're going to later!
Yay!
So I've seen luster dust be used in drinks before, particularly for D&D parties, which is where I got the idea from for this drink. I'm going to take the luster dust and stick it into a marinade kind of thing for our veggies, so that...
Oh, wow.
That'll... Yeah.
Yes!
So we're gonna see how much of this we can eat before we get sick. There's a whole tube of luster dust. I poured a lot of mine. Boop!
Yay! Cheers! To wizards!
Boop. Yeah! To learning!
Mmm. This smells divine. Oh! I like the limeade touch.
Yeah.
It's good.
Mmm. Mmm. It just looks so cool.
Wow.
I don't even want to drink it. I just want to keep looking at it.
Yeah. This is cool. And you made this up?
I mean, the whole drink?
Yeah.
Yeah. The luster dust thing, somebody had definitely used for a D&D thing before.
Sure, sure,
but,
sure.
But the entire rest of the drink is on me.
Guys. So, guys. Yeah. She does not get enough credit for what she does.
You know, I try. I try to make it cool. Alright. We're gonna have a lot to chop up today.
D&D cookbook.
I'm just gonna sell it on Amazon, because on Amazon you can publish anything.
Yeah! Paging Mike Merles! Paging Wizards of the Coast! Let's get a D&D cookbook!
Alright. We literally have to cut up everything.
It casts hypnotic pattern, too. It does. I'm ready to chop.
All right. I'm going to give you the onion and the meat. Sorry.
Oh, that's okay. Wait, what's the thing you have to do to make you not cry?
Cut it from one end.
Cut it from one end?
Yeah. And then I'm going to not punish you and take the baby cutting board this week.
Okay. Knife, please. Thanks. Boop, 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 boop. All right. So, I'm cutting up this onion for the fish.
Prismatic veggies is gonna be like its own kind of like veggie salad that'll lay underneath the fish wish. So the whole thing will be like the fish wish dish once it all comes together, but the prismatic veggies will be underneath it.
And the wish part of the dish is the fact that it rhymes with fish.
Right. Also, the luster dust will make it pretty.
Cool.
So yeah, but...
I have donuts! That's okay! Never apologize.
How are you gonna have a wish dish and not have it made out of fish? That just doesn't make any sense.
Prometheus asked, how was filming? Did you get lots of Evian served to you on silver platters? No, I did not. This was an indie film, and we had LaCroix. But anyway.
Just as good.
I know, I'm like hooked on LaCroix now.
Yeah, me too. It's like a new development.
They keep serving it on set, and I'm like, don't do this to me. But I just justify it with, what, it's $4 for a 12-pack, so...
If that, yeah.
That's as much as a bottle of wine. If I can keep myself off a bottle of wine, that's not a bad day.
Do you want to come over and have girl talk over some LaCroix?
Yeah, for real. But it was fun. It was a lot of fun. And my job was very easy. What am I doing? Just mincing it?
Yeah.
Just regular? Okay.
Make them nice and small, so like half of this.
Okay, yeah.
Cool.
But I played the town whore, so
you
I...
You did?
Not like actually, but I slept with a guy who's married, and I just called her that because I thought it was funny.
Is it set in Michigan?
Yeah. It's set where we shot it.
Nice. So yeah, you know, small town.
Yeah. But I had a lot of fun. My character was very fun, easy to play, and oh my gosh, everyone was so nice. Everyone. It was an incredible crew, an incredible cast. Can't wait. They're shooting right now. I can't wait for it to come out. It's called Up on the Glass. You can follow them on all social media. Up on the Glass is their handle for everything.
That's a great title.
Yeah, because of the glass on the dunes. There's a dune in Michigan called the Silver Lake Dunes, and there's no trees near it. So that's where glass can actually
be made.
Yeah.
If you ever saw Sweet Home Alabama, they weren't lying to you.
Oh, yeah. Why you want to marry me anyhow?
So I can kiss you anytime I want.
Yeah, a lot of fun. And he's not here right now, but I met up with JPAR Superfan for drinks and we played pool.
Oh, you did? It was in your Instagram story, I think.
Yeah, that was Joe.
Yeah, I heard you go, Joe! And I went, oh, JPAR.
That's JPAR Superfan.
Oh my god, I know him.
Oh my god, I met up with a superfan in real life.
Big day.
Between audiology and sleeping with married men, Jess has little time for much else, apparently. Yep, that's me. That's my life. Gosh.
What a good life that would be.
The movie I shot before I left, Bottoms Up, you would get a kick out of that character because she is actually bat-shitaki insane.
I like your usage there. That was great.
Bat-shitaki mushrooms, that's a thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
In Fantasyland.
They come from the deep caves.
They do.
Where only the real mushrooms grow. My god. I'm just gonna create story for fake ingredients that don't exist.
So, I have to say, I love the wizard class. It's one of my favorite classes, because I just love all magic users so much.
Yeah.
I love wizards because they are all brain. They use intelligence as their spellcasting modifier, and they basically, when they level up, they don't really get a lot of different things. Like, rogues get a lot of different things, bards get a lot of different things.
They're very consistent.
Druids as well, but yeah, wizards, it's just like you get more and more and more spells. Which to some people might be a little boring, and I get that. But wizards get access to
really
all the spells.
Like really cool spells.
And you have to be creative to use spells. You really do. Because if you're just gonna, you know, hit people with blasty stuff all the time, then how are you different from a fighter? You're not really that different.
No.
Wizards can be there for utility.
What right.
What are you gonna say?
And the fact that you have so many schools that kind of like shape the characters.
Yeah, it's very flavorful. I am a conjuration wizard because I went about it, because I liked the conjuration the best. I actually like divination a lot too because portent is super cool. Portent is the ability to roll two or three d20s in the beginning of each long rest each day. And you can choose to replace a roll later in the game with something that you have seen the future of. Amazing. It is an amazing thing that you get at third level. Super cool. But conjuration, I love how at third level they... Oh, yeah.
Who
that? Who? Oh, yay! Thank you for the gift to DC Last Air Prometheus.
You the best.
44 subs.
Oh my
44 god. 44 subs.
Absolutely. Probably record somewhere. Insane.
Thank you for
it's a record here.
For sure for us.
Oh, yeah.
It's an important spell, Exoskeleton.
Oh.
Portent? Or which one? But anywho, so I chose the school before I made the wizard. Do we want to talk about our characters?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. Do you want to start?
Sure. I have never played a wizard, nor did I think it would be cool to play a wizard, because our first DM that we had was like, oh, if you get your book stolen, you lose everything. And I was like, oh.
That's true.
I know some DMs who would do this just to fork me over.
Yeah.
So I've never even considered it. And then we were doing this episode, and I was like, all right. I'm like, because we've been trying to rotate through fighters and magic users.
Yeah, trying to keep it varied for the D&D series.
But I think we like magic users better, so we've gone through more of the magic users.
I think there's pretty much an even number of straight fighters, straight spellcasters, and then there's a mix.
Yeah.
You know? Like, druids are pretty tanky, too, like, for a spellcaster.
I feel like they fit in every category, but we don't need to get into how much I already love them. So I also was running late on time of like learning all of this, and so I went through the schools very, very quickly, and I was going to do, abjuration? And then I looked down a little further and saw Illusion, and I was like, ooh, fun! And so that's how I created a character, and was like, I like the mystery of things.
Mm-hmm.
And I think playing magic users, you do have the ability to play with mystery. So if there's a school all about that, that's what I'm going to do.
So what's the story then?
Adina. I stole her name.
Adina.
Adina. I stole her name from The Little Mermaid.
Oh, who's that?
Her sisters. You know, there's Adina, Adela, Aquata, Arissa.
Only you know that.
It's a song in Disney lore!
Only you know that.
Because originally I was going to make her a Triton because I like Tritons and think they're cool. And then once I saw the illusion thing, I decided just to have her be human. And so I kept the name, and I like having the mysterious character. I've done that a couple times. And so I also... Oh, I thought you were like...
Oh no, I'm itching my elbow, sorry. I am pointing at you with a knife, though.
Yes. Most of the time, magic seems to be more innate, like we were talking about that beforehand.
Sorcerers, yeah.
Yeah. Or like even to me, a druid, like the mm-hmm. stories that I've created, they're always sort of innate.
Yeah.
So having one where it's just a book and like a school and a
yeah.
choice.
Yeah.
Having her, she has a lost love and she didn't really know where to go with things and life didn't seem to have a straightforward point anymore. And so choosing to like go down this road of illusionment and keep that up so that life never really seemed real anymore.
Hmm. So she's troubled?
Yeah.
I mean, what D&D character?
I was gonna say.
Really. Everyone's got bad stuff in their past.
It's like an episode of This Is Us. It'll make you cry at some point or another.
I still haven't seen that
yet. Oh my god! But yeah, so.
It's in the movie.
You're in the movie.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, like, I usually build characters with very strong convictions, and so I wanted her to be more, like, she's troubled, but it's a very playful sort of thing, and I liked the fact that when you were reading up on Illusion, like, it's an entertainer of sorts.
Yeah,
and so having that sort of thing of being like, all of this stuff was lost, I don't really know what's real anymore, and then translating it into this sort of entertainment form.
That's really cool.
Shanks.
P.S. Onions are done.
Sweat.
Unless you want them smaller.
No, that's perfect and way more than I thought that was going to come out of that onion.
Yeah, it's a big onion. Big onion! I like Illusionist Wizard. My first D&D character was a gnome illusionist. Ooh, yeah, that'd be fun. Prometheus, I don't think I've ever played a wizard. I usually prefer sorcerers for their flexibility. Now... Sorcerers are flexible because of the meta magic, but I would argue that wizards can be more flexible because in exchange for meta magic, you get just an insane amount of spell slots and you get arcane recovery, where if you take a short rest, you get even more spell slots back. So
yeah, that's super cool.
Where a sorcerer has to... not has to, but would twin or quicken a spell to diversify or be more powerful, whatever. A wizard can just be like, you know what? I got like 6 more spell slots in my back pocket. I'm just gonna pound it out.
Just gonna...
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, no.
But I love sorcerers. Sorcerers are dear to my heart. My first ever D&D character was a sorcerer, so. I've played 2 sorcerers.
She was a sorcerer?
Loen?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's wild magic, remember?
Oh, right.
Yeah, I played a wild magic sorcerer, and I played a draconic sorcerer, because I played Daenerys.
You did?
Yeah, in a podcast.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's
a comedic podcast.
Perfect. And technically, you're playing another wizard.
Huh?
Well, I'm not pronouncing. You can't really talk about
it. Oh, well, those are sorcerers, though.
Oh, I thought you said it was wizard.
No. Loen was a wild magic sorcerer.
No, I'm saying now.
Oh. Wait, what?
Megara.
Oh, yeah, Megara now is a wizard. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, I'm just not great about picking the right spells to prep each day. That's true. I didn't think about that. Yeah, sorcerers are flexible because you don't have to prepare anything. That's very true. Yeah, you got me there. That is more flexible, for sure.
Sorcerers do.
You can just pick from whatever you have. But wizards can prepare like a lot of spells, like a lot of them. So what is there anything else I can chop?
If you want to pull off some of the leaves off of the parsley.
Oh, parsley.
And the cilantro.
And cilantro. Mm-hmm. Oh. Pull them off and put them
on this guy.
Okay. How much do you want?
Like a third of each bunch.
Okay. So, Adina.
Yes.
Who can cook?
Oh, I have a book to recommend to you.
Yeah?
It's called The Young Elites.
Is this like a real book?
It's a real book.
Okay.
If any of you have read it, holler. What am I missing? Wild Magic Sorcerer, that's pretty hardcore. Yeah, it is hardcore if you have a DM who plays along with you on that and makes you roll on the Wild Magic Search table. I had a plan B, which is always using Major Image to make a bear and a dragon having a tea party. That's hilarious.
That's
Major Image is really cool. No, this book is called The Young Elites, and it is about, so basically a sickness took over and it gave the certain people superpowers, essentially, but it's like medievally.
Mm-mm, done. I'm already sold on this book.
Yeah, and the powers are very cool, they're very unique, and the protagonist has the power of illusion.
Awesome.
And the way she uses it, it's like, I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it.
Honestly, I just finished a book this morning.
Yeah?
So, yeah.
I'm borrowing it from Michael. He might let me just give it to you.
I mean, I'm on a personal name basis with the librarians, so.
The Young Elites, yeah.
Awesome.
And I don't want to give anything away if you're going to read it, but.
Oh no, it sounds awesome.
She has to learn how to master her power of illusion,
mm-hmm.
And it's really cool. There's a guy with the power of, like, emotion. He can make you feel whatever you want.
Oh my god!
And it's really cool. One has the power of fire, but it's like, the way she describes it, it's so unexpected. And this is a young adult novel, so you expect that.
Okay.
But,
that's fine.
You know.
I read a lot of that these days.
Yeah. But, and once you finish it, I'll have to tell you what I think is the coolest part about it. You'll discover it yourself.
Yeah.
But it's got a cool twist.
Text me later, because I definitely am dropping off the 5 library books I read in the last 2 weeks tomorrow morning, and I need to go get more.
Yeah.
So.
There's a sequel and a third one, too, that I have on my Kindle.
Oh, yes!
The second one's called The Rose Society.
Ooh.
Anyway, it'd be cool if you like illusion wizards, because it kind of reminds me of your character, because she... Her illusion is a defense mechanism.
Yeah. I feel like illusion in characters usually is always covering something.
Yeah.
Like, there's...
Like, why did you learn that?
Right.
However, in this book, it's more like sorcery because you're born with it. It's not like she didn't, like... She learns how to master it and to be better at it, but, you know, like, you're born with it.
Mm-hmm.
So, Adina.
Yes. Yes.
Can you tell us about how you felt the first time you did a really great illusion spell?
It felt like reality was coming back more so than it had ever before. It felt like the most real thing I had done possibly in my entire life. I understand that it's an illusion, but it just felt real and grounded and kind of wonderful.
Thanks.
How did it feel for you?
Well, I will tell you about my character. Is this enough, cilantro?
Yeah, I think so. If not, I will pull some off while you are talking. But yeah.
Alright, do you need these separated from the parsley?
Yeah, you can throw them all together, because they're going to get chopped up together anyway.
Okay.
And put into the, marinade,
if I find where I put
the thing. Oh well. I'll use a bowl instead.
My parsley doesn't look like this. I'm growing French parsley or something?
Curly parsley?
Yes, curly.
Yes. So that is typically used as a garnish.
Curly parsley?
Yeah. It has a very earthy taste.
Hmm. I haven't eaten it yet.
As where this is usually a little more flavorful and has its own sort of taste to it. Mm. Whenever dishes like pasta, when you do olive oil and lemon and parsley, this is what you would use.
Mm. I just grew it because it grew well with the basil.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah, also, if you ever need basil, please let me know, because my basil's getting out of control.
Girl, I will.
If you need it personally, not even for damsels and dishes. I have so much basil.
Really?
And I never use it.
Oh my god, I use basil all the time.
Yeah, like, seriously, I'll bring you a handful of fresh basil.
Yeah.
A large handful.
Especially because then you can, like, the smart thing to do is to take an old ice cube tray. So you cut up a bunch, and then you melt some butter, and then you throw in the basil, and throw in, like, a couple, like, you can throw in oregano, or you can throw in cilantro, or whatever you want to sort of mix it with, and then you pop them in the ice cube trays, like, pour it in, freeze it, and then when you go to cook chicken or fish or whatever, you pop it out into the pan, and then you have, like, herb butter ready to go.
What?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna need you to write that down for me.
That's all you gotta do. You just put it in the ice cube tray.
What?
Yeah.
I need to get myself an ice cube tray specifically dedicated to herb butter.
Oh, it's so good. I used to do it in our old house a lot.
Fresh cilantro in small amounts is a burst of freshness, much more than that. And you start feeling a spice, still very fresh, bright flavor. It's a lovely herb. Yes, it is. We actually talked about this last time we ate cilantro, I think, is that we really like it, but some people think it tastes soapy.
Yeah, I still don't understand it.
It's just, it's how some humans are, really. It's not personal, it's like how they actually taste.
Well, yeah, because everybody's taste buds are just a wee bit different.
Yeah. So, let me tell you about Fahima. Also, do you want me to tap these or no? Just throw them on there.
Yeah, throw them on here.
So, Fahima, as you know, is a fire genasi. I need to keep drinking this. What am I doing? Her father was a scholar, is a scholar. And he went exploring in a desert area cave, and he was an erudite, so he just loved to learn and gather knowledge. And he found, lo and behold...
I thought you were going to say, he found Loen. I was like...
he found an Afridi bottle. And he opened it, and out popped an Afridi. And he made a wish. He wished... for a child, because he had spent his whole life being a scholar and never found love and always wanted a child. And so, out popped little baby Fahima.
So cute! Yeah. I didn't know that!
Yeah, so she's half genie, half human, because she's kind of a combo of the genie that granted the wish and him. And she grew up learning everything. He was so dedicated to her. And she went off to school where she met Persephone, Elena's character. And
Persephone.
Then, as his age advanced, the thing most precious to him, other than Fahima, his mind, began to fall away from him. He started to lose his memory. He started to get like kind of Alzheimer's.
Oh, that's bad.
Yeah. And so Fahima's goal in life is to gather as much knowledge as possible and build up her father's library so he can always have the knowledge she accrued. And she also seeks to find some way to reverse what's happening to him, but I don't know that would really happen. Maybe if she got so advanced of a wizard, she could do wish.
There you go.
She could wish for her father to not lose his memories anymore. I don't know.
You're like your own little Meredith Grey.
Meredith Grey?
Yeah, from Grey's Anatomy. Her mom has Alzheimer's. And so she worries that she'll get it or, like, pass it on to her children. So, like, her biggest desire is to find a cure for it.
Mm. Yeah.
And because, you know, the whole surgery thing, she's obviously very much into books and, like, that sort of thing.
Mm. But, yeah, Fahima is a little socially stunted because she spent most of her life with her dad. I'm actually going to pull up my story because I know I'm forgetting a detail in here. Somehow. I write down all my backstories and I keep them in my D&D file.
It's weird that you say she's like socially stunted because of some of the characters that you've made.
And, like, she always seemed sort of sweet and, like, easy to get along with.
Ah. What, Fahima?
Yeah.
Yeah, she is, but she's just awkward.
Yeah. Maybe I'm, like, drawn to the awkward characters that are just kind of like, hi.
Yeah. They're not your typical adventurers. Let's see here. Let's see. Aw. You'd let me turn a blind eye to me staying up past my bedtime reading by my firelight under the covers. Oh, is your peach? You're so cute.
I feel like you write a little novel for each of your characters, which is awesome.
I do. His most esteemed possession, his once infallible and amazing mind, is now slowly trickling away.
That's so
In his
depressing.
Moments of lucidity, he had encouraged me to go out into the world and explore as he once did. It's so cute. But actually, I forgot. I changed her. So when I actually play her as a long-term character, I'm changing her to Fahima Scamander. And she is in the parallel universe Newt Scamander's daughter. I think I've talked about this before.
I have never heard this. This is awesome. No.
Oh, I thought I talked about this. Yeah, so she is Newt Scamander's daughter in a parallel universe where he never married and he was a scholar and everything, but add the animals in there. So she would be a multi-class of... she would be half wizard, half shepherd druid.
What?
So she can communicate with animals. So she's basically Newt Scamander in female form, is my next character.
That's cute.
Yeah.
I like it. I like it a lot.
Because, I don't know, I think I just got a little, I just wanted a little extra oomph in there. I didn't want just straight wizard. I wanted, because I love the new Xanathar's classes, but I was like, oh! The shepherd druid is amazing!
Yeah, the druids in that are phenomenal. Yeah. Like, not gonna help me pick other classes if you just keep making even cooler druids.
Yeah, so the idea is... yeah, talking to animals and... I don't know. Conjuring stuff. I haven't really fleshed out that side of her too much yet. I just know that that's what I'm drawn to for my next character, because my last two big characters, Barbarian and Warlock, I want something a little different. You see this photo of her? You've seen this, right?
No, I've never seen this for her. Do you use, like, some site builder for this?
Yeah, I did.
Where I'm like, I always see that you do these for your different characters.
I'm gonna see if I can... Yeah, I'm gonna show you guys Fahima. This is what I imagine she. This is what I imagine I look like right now. Hold on, I'll show you. I'll show you. Hold on. Also, two glasses. Thanks. They're fake. They're my fake Harry Potter glasses.
You gotta do the Harry Potter thing.
What?
Where Daniel Radcliffe, in between scenes when he was younger, used to stick his fingers through it because there was no glass in those.
Oh yeah, these don't have any glass in them. Okay, let me insert my media file. Let's see, where is it? Geek, D&D. Where is she?
Who are you looking for?
I'm looking for Fahima. Oh, maybe I didn't download her. Whoops. How do I download? Download. D&D. Fahima character. Okay, it's ready.
Whew!
There she is. So, she's Fire Genasi, but she looks mostly human. It's just like her hair is fiery and crackles, like the frizz crackles with fire.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I always think fire, like Genasi, would be really fun characters if they ever did a D&D movie.
Yeah.
Because like the costume design alone would be really cool, but you'd have to have someone doing really great CGI to have like your hair blowing or like having the water movement. It'd be really cool.
Yeah, it's kind of like, actually Lexi looks more like her outfit than I do right now. But the glasses,
it's
yeah.
It's just an illusion.
Yeah. But she, yeah, she's very like Newt Scamander-y.
I like that you always base your characters off of something that inspires you from like film or TV or whatever, and then give them this really cool twist.
Well, that's really just been my last two characters, because Kira isn't based on anything, and neither is Adele.
I thought Kira was based on something in a book.
Mm-mm.
Oh.
No.
Well, never mind then.
Adele as well was all from my brain.
I knew Adele was.
But Zell was definitely Rapunzel.
No kidding.
Yeah. Real original name.
Whee!
The fish, it's here, the fish. How much was that?
$5.
That's it?
Yeah.
Dang. That's a beautiful piece of meat. I want to food cam that. Let's food cam that fish.
Boom.
It kind of looks like a heart. Wow. You see that? That is a nice piece of a fish.
Mm-hmm. That ajito.
Look how thick it is.
Yeah. We're going to cut it in half so that we can have one to share now and one for camera later. Sound like a Disney movie. I've been immersed in the Disney world a lot right now.
You're what in it?
Just like immersed myself in it a lot lately.
Why?
Well, because of the project we're working on, and then the trailer for Wreck-It Ralph 2 came out.
Oh, I haven't seen it. Good? Breaks the internet? I heard about that. I don't know if I was the biggest fan of the first one, though.
I haven't seen the first one.
Oh.
But the trailer, so it's kind of spoilery, but not really. The trailer,
well, it's a trailer, so it's out there for the public anyway.
I don't, the girl with the candy stuck all over her body.
Vanellope?
So they get themselves into the internet, and then it's like, obviously, like, major corporations, and one of them is the Disney Corporation. So she, like, trots on in, and then she's trying to get herself away from something and poops into another room, and it's all of the actual Disney princesses, like, just hanging out.
Oh!
And so, like, Rapunzel's brushing her hair, and, like, Anna and Elsa are talking, and Pocahontas has, like, a druid-looking staff kind of thing.
But Megara's not there.
No.
Me.
She's not a real one.
She's married to a god.
I mean...
demigod.
I would count her. Also, Rapunzel's a really big part of it, and just the writing is really great, where she's like, I'm a princess, and they're like, what did they say? Like, they go through, it's like, do you have magic hair? Or do you have magic hands? And Elsa does, like, an ice thing. And it was like, have you been kidnapped or enslaved? Or, like, those kind of, like, jokes. And it, then Rapunzel steps forward and is like, does everybody think that a big, strong man saved your life? And she's like, yeah! And they're like, she is a princess!
Oh! That's funny. I want to watch it.
So I'm curious as to, like, how that movie's going to be. Like, how much they're all going to be involved in, or...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm sure they're not going to be involved in very much, and that was just, like, a nice blip for us to see, but...
I want to see Wreck-It Ralph.
And all of the art is done in Wreck-It Ralph style, so it's, like, all of the Disney princesses in that format. Oh, yeah, Snow White's like, were you poisoned? No.
Okay, we're totally going to watch this.
Yes! I've watched it like 100 times.
I'm going to pause the music. We're going to watch this trailer. I don't know if you can, like... Can we put it on our video?
I think so.
It's just a trailer.
I mean, when you... Some people do. Like, you're watching video games and stuff when other people are playing, and that's, like, art. I don't know. I would say it's okay.
Yeah. Add source. Screen capture.
Or, like, they'll see game trailers and be like, here's my opinion of them. So I feel like trailers are fine.
Yeah. Let's do that. I'm getting it ready.
Right. Do that. Get that ready. So while we were talking about all the D&D stuff, and then we jumped into Wreck-It Ralph, I took our carrots, our onions, and our yellow peppers and threw them into our skillet with some garlic salt and olive oil. So those are all sauteed up. Now we're gonna let them cool because we're gonna add tomatoes and then avocado. So you get that prismatic color going.
Yay! Okay. We're gonna watch this trailer.
Let's do it!
I'm excited.
Let's get you plugged in. Wifey, or is it wifey?
Why don't we just go in?
And we are online. Excited. Just one minor thing. What is the internet? Oh, holy cow! Look at all this stuff.
Congratulations, you're a winner!
Really?
These 10 child stars went to prison. Number 6 will amaze you.
That sounds interesting.
Ralph, come on!
Redirecting to eBay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next item up, a black velvet painting of a sorrowful kitten.
It's like it's looking into my soul.
Yeah, that one's really gonna haunt me for a while.
Whoa, games!
Pancake. Milkshake.
On my way, kids.
Pancake.
Milkshake. Milkshake. I'm starting to understand why people like this game. Very zen. Milkshake.
Hey, look what I found! More pancakes.
Let's speed it up. Pancake, 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 pancake. Eat, little buddy. Eat.
Ralph, you might want to try feeding the kitty for a little while.
No, the kitty gets the milkshake. The bunny gets the pancake.
Yeah, try the teaser one, because that's
which is the teaser. This?
I think so. It's the Wreck-It Ralph Disney Princess. Like, that should pop it up.
We want to see the good one!
Oh my god, honestly, it'll blow your flippin'.
Disney Princess.
Princess!
We got the actual actresses who played the princesses in the original films to come back.
That's the other amazing thing. Every original voice outside of, I think, Snow White, because she's dead, came back to...
Why can I not find it? Yeah.
Hi. Whoa, whoa, ladies, I'm a princess too.
What kind of a princess are you?
Do you have magic hair?
No.
Magic hands?
No.
Do animals talk to you?
No.
Were you poisoned?
No.
Cursed?
No.
Kidnapped or enslaved?
No. Are you guys okay? Should I call the police?
Do people assume all your problems got solved because a big, strong man showed up?
Yes. What is up with that?
She is a princess.
Ralph breaks the internet.
Yay!
Because a big strong man came in and solved all your problems.
I just really wish they had Megara so I had some pointers.
I mean, don't let Jess fool you. Her Megara voice is spot freaking on.
Hopefully.
No, it's so good. Because I was sitting next to her when we were working on it, and I literally was just like, oh my god, I don't like her. I gotta work on my tangle.
Well, she says work on my tangle. Oh yeah, does she have like an airy voice?
Rapunzel?
Yeah.
You just heard her where she was like, do you have magic hair?
Everything
is really sing-songy.
Whereas Megara just talks like she's annoyed with everything all the time. She has a kind of airy voice, though, when she talks.
Yeah, I don't know how you do that. Because you do it so, like, even keel, where I'm like, alright.
I don't know.
Do you have magic hair? Yeah, I'm super excited for that to come out.
What did they say? Were you imprisoned or enslaved?
Yeah. Should I call the police? Does everyone think that your problems were solved because a big, strong man came in to save you?
Cool.
I mean, it's true, though, for a lot of the princesses. Like, Snow White would have stayed there unless Prince kissed her on the lips.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Same with Cinderella. I mean, Sleeping Beauty.
Oh, yeah.
So...
the real OG princesses are definitely, like, couldn't help themselves at all. Like, I...
because they're based on a fairy tale that's from a period where women didn't.
Well, you know? So is Rapunzel and everything else. It was just, that was the timing of things, where Snow White came out in the 40s, and then Sleeping Beauty was... Elena's way better at this. Elena knows her Disney
years.
Yeah. Which is so weird. Like, her Disney facts are all over the place, but you ask her what year a Disney movie came out, and she's got it.
Who are the Disney wizards? I feel like they're only bad guys.
You know? Well, wouldn't, Arthur, Sword in the Stone.
Yeah.
And Mickey.
But those aren't Disney princesses.
Oh, no, there is no Disney princess that's a wizard. There's not really Disney princesses that are full-blown magic users. Like,
yeah, that's true. What There's just magic in their world.
What would Rapunzel be? She's a magic user. And then...
what magic does she do?
Her hair is healing. And reverses age.
Oh. So she is just magical. That's not really anything.
No.
Class-wise, I guess.
Mm-mm.
Sleeping Beauty, 1959. Snow White, 1938. Thank you! Human Encyclopedia! Internet! Mm-hmm.
1938.
What are you doing there?
I'm just taking the sides of the ahi and, like, rolling it in the seasoning.
Give it a little massage.
Just a little massage. They've been coated in cayenne and then garlic salt. Should give them a little heat.
Cool.
And then we're gonna, I'm waiting for the skillet to heat up, and then we're gonna throw them on there.
Yay!
We need that skillet to be nice and hot to give it the good sear.
So how long would you say this recipe takes if you weren't hosting a show?
Oh, like, maybe 30 minutes.
Really?
Probably, yeah, because, like...
I feel like the chopping took me, like, 10 minutes alone, though.
Oh, that's true. Because, see, that's a hard question, because I'm focusing on hosting a show, but I also have somebody helping me.
True.
So, maybe like 45 to an hour, because you do have to like chop up all the stuff, and then those have to cook. So, if you cook your carrots, your onion, and your pepper first and throw them in, and then keep cutting everything else, you could probably do it in like 40. But you also need them to cool down a little bit so that it's not hot when you stick tomatoes and avocado in there, because it'll mesh with it a little.
You're using avocado?
Yeah.
Nice.
Instead of a dressing, we're going to have like a cilantro, a chimichurri-esque sort of marinade kind of thing. Mm. But I'm really into this salad at Heirloom, and they don't, it's like a Caesar salad, but they don't use Caesar dressing. It's like a Caesar vinaigrette with avocado mashed into it.
Yum. So okay. It coats healthier.
It. Yeah, and it coats it really well.
So how long are you going to leave the fish on there?
I've never made ahi before. So start your timers, and we'll go from there.
It is 8:57.
Yeah, it's only 8:57.
I know, yeah. Huh. I've been just yammering away. Time has been moving so slowly because you got to listen to me talk about my backstory.
No, I missed you last week. It was weird.
It was weird. I feel like it's been a long time since we've done Damsels in... well, for me it has been. Because I've been out for 2 weeks.
Right. But I don't count that as, like, a real episode. Like, it is a real episode, and I'm very glad that they were here. But you and I have actually gotten really great at being like, I'll cut this. Or, like, we know how to converse. Where, because they have a podcast where they're constantly, like, facing each other and can kind of give each other pauses.
Mm.
And they were so excited about the topic. Like, they were so excited about Weird Al. I was just like, I don't know how to talk and, like, keep all of this stuff moving. But also, like... I'm technically my show, so I have to talk.
Yeah.
Ah!
Just let them run on for,
the entire 2 hours.
Yeah, 2 hours.
But yeah, it was, I forgot his name already, because I met him that night. Not Dan, obviously, the other one that was in there. He was really great at, like, sensing me start to move, and then be like, whoop!
Yeah, I saw when I logged on, they were standing, like, way back here.
Yeah. He kept, like, positioning himself really well, and, like, I think at one point I noticed he was standing like this to be able to, like, rock away from me and, like, get out of my way, and I was like, cool. And then Dan had just burrowed himself in the corner. Yeah. It was definitely weird to be working with other people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Testosterone in the room. Lex did a great job. Don't let her tell you otherwise.
I tried really hard.
I listened to you on mute for a couple minutes.
You sure did. A lot of people did, apparently.
Oh, yeah?
Well, their podcast apparently got a ton of listens. What is that? It's not views. It's...
Yeah, listens? Clicks? I don't know. Ah! I splashed myself in the face.
That get you? That get you real hard? Alright.
My glasses are fake, so I didn't stop the splash.
How rando would that be if all of a sudden you saw it just... My magic isn't working. Alright. So those are gonna go.
I should button this up. That's what I should do. This is more wizardy. Could button it up.
Oh.
Is it like a real vest?
I like that. That's super cute.
Yeah.
And like
better.
Sort of
more flattering.
Fishery too. Where I feel like it's multi-purposeful.
Like I'm going fishing. Got this weird knot, but I gotta get rid of that.
Going to fish school?
I'm going to conjure some trout.
Why did you pick that as her voice?
Irish?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know why I picked Irish.
I always liked the fact that... Because when we were talking about voices, I didn't really know how D&D worked. And I was told that people picked... like British for a high elf and that kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And I wanted to do Southern for Dahlia and have her just be kind of like...
Southern, you said?
Everything she says is kind of Southern drawl.
Mm.
And have her have that sort of personality. And he was like, nobody ever does Southern. That's an American thing. You can if you want. He was like trying to be supportive. I had to match that in. But he was like, I've never heard of anybody doing that. And I was like, okay, I'll do British then because I feel like I need to have... some sort of dialect the first time we do this.
I think I need a fork, actually. Because this bowl is too narrow for the smasher.
But yeah. And then we started, and you made Loan French.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's so cool! Because I feel like now I am in a lot of games where the ton of them are British. And I'm like, that's so weird that that's...
Well, I think it's just the easiest
dialect,
kind of, like, foreign thing to do, you know?
Oh, yeah. It makes perfect sense, but...
But I have had many accents.
What was, the barbarian was just its own sort of thing, right?
Kira Vistania, she's kind of like, she's like French mixed with English, mixed with, like, just
Jamaican?
Kind of like Jamaican kind of sounding, yeah. Then, of course, Adele is very high British.
Oh, she is.
Very high. Loan, of course, is French, as you mentioned, and Pima is Irish. Sphinx is also very tall, but she had sort of a lower voice because she was mannish.
Mannish.
She looked like a boy. That's the idea. Who else do I got? Oh, Zell. Oh, Zell's sort of like, she's British, but she's sort of lower. She's like, I don't give a rat boss what you think of me.
She's a little cockney.
Yeah, like a little bit. She's like Estro, somewhere down there.
Yeah, I like that they all have accents.
But a lot of British, you know?
Yeah, I mean...
It's just easier.
It is. It's the one that most people jump to. But I enjoyed the French and the Irish.
You missed all my NPCs. You got.
Oh, yeah, you have to fill me in on all of that.
I introduced. So I ran my second campaign as a DM.
And I had food poisoning, so I couldn't go.
I know, Lexi missed out. I met all of the NPCs, and I gave them all voices. And my favorite was Sister Gail. Gariel? Because
She had the voice of Michelle Williams in I Feel Pretty. She was kind of like this. There's a banshee who has something that I want.
Oh my god!
If you want to get it for me, then you can.
That's amazing! And the men, of course.
And then there's the goblins.
Oh, the goblins are my favorite. Yeah. Definitely met the goblins.
Can you make it next Tuesday?
Yes.
You can?
Yes.
Because you didn't mark it on the poll.
I am possibly going on vacation. Which is why...
Oh, okay.
Because my work schedule has been all over the place. If I don't leave on vacation, which it seems like at this point, I would be going, like, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, would work out. But we have rehearsal next week. One day.
Oh, yeah, Wednesday. On Wednesday.
I thought this week was Wednesday.
Yes, it is. This week is Wednesday, next week is Friday.
Gotcha.
Friday night.
Oh yeah, I could not do Friday. Are you doing this week or next week?
I'm doing both.
Oh.
Because my D&D game got canceled on Wednesdays.
It did?
Not forever, but just for the next 2 weeks.
Oh.
Because one of our guys is going to be gone. And April's gone.
Where's April?
Well, she can't play anymore because she works for Blizzard.
Oh, right. That commute, though.
Yep. She can't do anything. I haven't seen April in like 100 years.
Gotta get it, the band back together.
So hopefully you can make it Tuesday.
Yeah.
Because I don't think Chandler can make it. I think he's doing like finals and stuff.
Finals for what? Isn't he a baby?
No, he's our age. I think that he's getting a degree.
Oh, gotcha.
In something. I always forget.
Getting a degree in something.
I've always wondered what it feels like to be just undeniably free. Did you see that movie? Did you see it? I saw it.
What is that movie even about?
You didn't see it?
No.
I
heard that voice and like I've heard about it, but I don't know. But
it's exactly what the trailer says it's about.
Oh, great.
She gets knocked on the head, thinks she's, you know, this, what she always imagined she was, or whatever she thinks beautiful is to her, and it's very, very cheesy rom-com, like, people hate on it, but it's like, what did you expect? There are so many 90s and 2000s movies where it's just like cheesy, cheesy, cheesy romantic comedies, and that's pretty much exactly what they did with this one. But people, I don't know, for some reason they have higher expectations, and I don't know why.
I mean,
I don't think it's fair.
I think horror and drama and things are kind of breaking the boundaries. I have yet to see a real rom-com break the boundary.
Oh, no, Sleeping with Other People. Sleeping with Other People.
Not a rom-com.
No?
No, that's a dramedy. Like, there's not...
What? I think it's a rom-com.
No!
I think you're elevating it to a dramedy because it's so good.
Maybe my brain is always like, well, you know what?
It's a romance and it's a comedy. It is a little sad, but aren't all rom-coms a little sad at some point?
No, not all of them. Me Before You was devastating.
I might have been coerced into it. Listen, we've all seen it, except for Lexi.
What?
I Feel Pretty. Yeah. I do want to see Book Club, though. You saw it? Was it good?
So good!
I played Euchre with my grandma for like 5 hours with her friends, all
that
her old lady
so
friends.
Cute.
And they were all like, we can't wait to see this book club movie. Oh my god! And one of them saw it and she was like, oh my god, the way they talk, it's just like us! Ah! I was just laughing my head off! And it was good?
It was so good. Actually, Miranda and I went to go see it. And we went and like had a girls' night afterward and I was like, that's us, like once we're old.
I know.
And like you had the one that was like kind of crotchety and had a cat, and then you had the other one that was like, I just believe in love.
Aww.
And like I just want, like, maybe we just need to spice things up again to save our marriage, or like
keep our marriage going. And then Jane Fonda, God bless her.
She's like the Cynthia, or the Samantha.
She's the Samantha. But she does it in a way that, you can't even compare her to Samantha. Like, she has this heart right off the go and is a little more standoffish and not like, I know I'm everything, but like I know what I'm good at. I wear the pants in every situation.
I gotta see it.
Oh, I would go like seven more times. It was so
good. Would you see? Oh, you can't see it in a movie pass,
I would
though.
Pay to go see it again.
Like, really?
It was so good.
Okay.
And honestly, it made me want to be like, okay, we need to make a book club. Because at the very beginning, they talk about they've been doing it for like 30 years or something, or 40 years, where I'm like,
let's do that! Let's do book club!
I want to do, especially because you and I have been swapping books and talking about books for a little
let's
bit now.
Let's do it! Also, this is relevant to wizards because wizards use spell books.
Right, if we're going to talk about books, now is the episode.
Hi, J-Par Superfan! Hello! I already told them that we hung out in Michigan.
We did. In fact, I saw it on her Instagram story and I was like, I know him!
That's Joe! That's the Joe! The Joe from the Clue episode!
The Joe! I really want to see Ocean's 8 this weekend.
It's I didn't know that was out.
Yeah, it came out last weekend. But I saw Heredity instead.
Which Lexi said was not good.
I have opinions. If anybody's seen Heredity, please let me know what your opinions are. Also, I think my opinions, I'm just going to keep saying it like that, were a little skewed because next to me was this couple, and they were canoodling, which is fine.
Thank you! Thank you for the gift sub! Thank you, Prometheus, that's 45! 45! 45!
You pulling that Disney princess voice out?
Ha! 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 That's good, right?
Yeah, and now we don't have to worry about copyright because you changed it.
changed into something terrible that
I
no
enjoyed
one wants to hear
it
again.
The people next to us were on their cell phone, and not just like one text and done. Left the volume on.
I legit yell at those people. I tap them on the shoulder and go, "Hey, put your phone away."
But the thing that was nuts is I'm not that ballsy of a person.
It doesn't take balls. What are they gonna do to you? The worst that happens, they're gonna go, fuck you. I mean, fork you.
I like how that, like, sort of scared both of us. But yeah, I was super excited about the movie, and so the people behind them kept going, shh, every time the phone would go, ding. And so it was like this, ding, shh, ugh. I'm like, okay, if we can all be quiet. Like,
that's very frustrating.
Yeah, so, and I, like, leaned over to Dan at one point, and I was like, I can't focus.
Yeah, that's when you yell at him.
Yeah.
I've done it plenty of times.
I'm the passive-aggressive person who's like, do they have to, like, don't they know to turn their phone off really loud?
Apparently not.
Which, no. Well, and then, like, it was every sound. It wasn't just texting. It was, like, a Twitter notification, and then, like, a doom-doom-doom-doom-doom-doom-doom, and I'm like, how? And
rude.
They did not like the movie, which I wanted to like the movie, just to disagree with them. But he was like, this is dumb. Oh, she crazy. And I'm like, stop.
Rude.
Stop.
We can fix that in post. Nah. I usually throw popcorn at those kinds of people.
I ate all my popcorn. I ate a big bag of popcorn.
Oh, now I want to go see a movie.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't been to a movie in a bit. In a hot bit. When's the last time I saw a movie? MoviePass can tell me. What's that?
Oh, hey, thanks!
Moldy Fort! Yay, thank you for the subscription on Twitch Prime!
Also, great name.
Moldy Fort, Moldy Fort, Moldy, 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 Moldy,
Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, Moldy, That's pretty well timed.
It was. Alright, MoviePass, what's the last movie I saw?
Oh, have you been selected to be one of the great people that now gets to take a photo of their ticket?
No, but Michael has.
It's coming for you. Because it started with either Dan and then Kelleher got it and I got it. Or vice versa. But I was the last person and I just got it this week.
Ugh. Last movie I saw was Deadpool 2.
Oh, wow. That has been a little bit.
Yeah. But I've been pretty good about seeing 2 movies a month.
Which, to get
my money's worth.
Well, really, out here, you only need to see one.
Yeah, but I do try to do 2. Hello, Voldemort. Hello! We haven't actually done a Harry Potter episode yet.
It's coming.
Because we have it on such a high pedestal.
Well, I also feel like people have done the recipes where I don't know what I would do.
Well, I have a Harry Potter cookbook. Oh no, Alicia does. We can borrow it.
But I feel like we've been on this roll of like having our own recipes.
Yeah.
And so, you know.
We can always do Harry Potter cake pop. Mm-hmm. Easy enough.
Like a pumpkin cake pop.
Pumpkin.
Yeah, like a pumpkin.
I was thinking like Harry Potter heads.
But it's gotta be like a pumpkin spice cake.
Oh. Yeah. But why? Because of the
What cake would you use?
Oh, I don't know. Just vanilla.
Nah, girl.
We have velvet cake, so it's like blood. You can bite into the head.
I don't know, something about pumpkin cake is like sticking with me.
They eat pumpkin pasties.
Yeah. Well, we can pumpkin
make
pumpkin juice.
We can make pumpkin pasties because the ones at Harry Potter World suck.
I have not had one. I did have the pumpkin juice, though.
Bad.
That pumpkin juice is good.
The butterbeer is great, too, but...
It's so sugary.
The pumpkin pasty is the one that's like, it looks like a pierogi, right? It's like a...
Yeah.
Oh. It was awful.
Is it supposed to taste like pumpkin pie in the middle, or is it supposed to be savory?
Don't know. Sweet, for sure, but it was like dry. Yeah. Not great. Oh, wow.
Oh no, I cooked all the way through.
You didn't want it to?
No. Oh well. Oh well.
That looks amazing. It's still tender though.
Mm-hmm.
Yum.
Mm. Alright. Let's do this.
Wow. Oh, I'm so hungry. And they have pumpkins in Hagrid's garden. That's true. Yeah. Is this the picture plate? Or is this the eat plate?
It can be the eat plate.
Yay! For those of you who don't follow us on Instagram, follow us at Damsels and Dishes, where you can see the final product of these beautiful dishes. And us in, like, semi-costume.
Yeah. From the waist up, because I've got Spanx on.
Yeah. We're in shorts because it's hot today in LA.
It's been miserable lately. Hold on.
I'm so excited.
Hold on.
I'm gonna food cam this. It's time to food cam. Food cam. Food cam. This ahi tuna, cause it deserves it. It is so good. Wow.
Actually, we're not gonna put that on ours because we're gonna save this for the, but this.
Just a little bit. Wow, do you see that? Sparkly butter. Can we just have a little bit?
I mean, this is technically olive oil, but...
Oh, olive oil. We can make more.
No, we're out of olive oil.
Oh. It's glittering! Do you guys see that? It's glittering!
So it's the wish fish dish.
Oh my god! Focus.
Focus,
camera. Focus. Come on. Come on. Well, it's not gonna focus.
No, it's pretty good. I like that.
But look at, you see that glitter? That is actual glitter.
That luster dust, though. Mm.
Yeah. You can pick that up from the Hobby Lob, or the Joanne, or the Michaels.
So, if anybody was timing us, you need to cook...
I was. 20 minutes.
So you need to take, like, 10 minutes to cook your ahi. But I cooked ahi for the first time! Heyo!
It's sparkly! I know, I wish you would focus on it and get it closer, though, because it's, like, blurry. Come on.
You're gonna have fun taking photos after the show, though.
Wow.
But I do like that presentation, so that's what we're gonna go with for round two.
Wow.
But wow. You got all them veggies in there?
I can't wait to put you in my mouth.
And because of how book smart they are, like, in all of their knowledge, it's all healthy and has a lot of power veggies.
Power veggies!
Ah! Boom.
Uh-oh.
What'd you do?
Prometheus just sent us something on Twitter and I'm scared. I'm scared. What did you send us?
Those veggies are good. I know how to make some good healthy food.
It's not showing up. It's not showing up. Where is it? Moldivore! Moldy, 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 mo long.
Yeah, it definitely doesn't feel like it.
I could use a remix of that song you just composed. It's from a YouTube video, Joe.
Called Harry Potter Puppet Pals.
It's amazing, and I was obsessed with it when I was in college.
Ron Weasley. Harry Potter. Ooh. Harry Potter.
Why
Potter.
Is it? Yeah. It's a camera with a cross through it.
Huh?
I can't see it. Maybe it's private. Look, it's not showing me. See? It's not showing me! I don't know why. Harry Potter.
Ooh!
Harry Potter. Hermione. Ron. Ron Weasley. Oh, the file size. Half a year of damsels and mamsels. Oh, I need a fork. Where's the fork?
Sorry.
There's only one?
Yeah, I have one.
Oh, okay.
She's the one that's in the bowl.
Yay!
Or my hands, because I'm a heathen.
Oh my god, I'm gonna eat this ahi tuna! Oh, you know what? I never turned the music back on.
Has there been no music this entire episode?
Ever since we watched the YouTube video, no. You know, I guess we don't need it to distract from our beautiful personalities.
No, our charm and wit is so fantastic.
You don't like fish?
Hmm? I had some over here.
Hmm.
Do you like it?
Mm-hmm. I mean, seafood is my fave. Mmm. This is my happy wish dish dance. A wish dish. I got a wish dish. It's a happy flippity floppity fish wish dish. Yeah. I'm a wizard. And I eat foods that have spells in their name. I like spell dishes. I like wishity 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 fish dishes. This is going in the file.
I'm really proud of you for that.
This is going in the file of clips that I never want to see of myself.
I also really want a compilation of every dance break we've ever had together. I feel like that would be really good.
Good? Yeah. Good? Is good the adjective we want to use here?
Funny.
Don't know if it is.
I think it'd be really funny.
You're dancing because this dish is so fucking good.
I can't tell if you swore or censored it.
I said fork. Fork. Also, why are you scared of me sending you stuff?
Listen.
I'm scared of anyone sending me stuff, no matter how much I trust them. Every time I get an image file from Michael, I'm like, oh my god, where is this gonna be?
Yep, I feel the same way when you send me stuff, and I'm like, we have to send each other stuff all the time. I always, like, feel like I'm gonna get in trouble when I get, like, an image. Hmm. Or on Messenger, it'll be like, so-and-so has sent you a photo, and I'm like...
Yeah, so it's like, what is it gonna be? Is it gonna be funny or is it gonna be weird and gross?
Am I gonna have a response to this?
It's a fish wish dish with prismatic veggies. It's so good, it makes me want to do a dance. Yeah. It's a wizard dish. I'm damsels and dishes. It's a wizard dish. That's all I got.
The first round was really great. Michael is a wholesome and innocent boy. He is wholesome. He's very wholesome.
If wholesome means...
I'm skipping over innocent.
It's an alternative meaning for wholesome. Holy into experiencing life.
Yes. He's also a really good cook, though.
He is. I love going to Michael's place because he always makes me food.
He made snacks for D&D and that was dank.
Yeah, he's vegetarian, so he always has to cook. And he is good at it.
I think I want to make snacks next time. Because it's next week, right? It's not this week, obviously.
The 19th.
Oh, okay.
How is Elena holding up? I've seen her tweets about her ankle. Not great.
She's been having some rough news.
She does a lot of stuff that
It requires her to walk, so she's not having a great time. She also drives a scooter and doesn't have a car, and she can't take her crutches on her scooter, so she has to Uber everywhere.
Which is expensive.
And that's also another thing bogging her down.
We gotta get her, like, a crutch holder.
I know, like a backpack. But she is getting a car soon.
Yay! Mm. Ahi tuna is the best fish.
Mm. I'm glad you like it, because you don't like fish normally.
Ahi tuna is, like, my one... If it's cooked correctly, like, this was a little too well done for me. I do like it when it's pink.
Mm, me too, generally.
So I was like, oh, this is not going to taste good. It's still good. Mm-hmm. So I like ahi tuna any way you want to prepare it.
Mm-hmm.
I liked the tilapia the last time we did it. I think I'm starting to like fish. I don't really like fresh crab cakes. I learned that the hard way last week. We went to the beach. And have you ever been to Neptune's Net yet?
Mm-hmm. The motorcycle place.
So good. They're free.
Oh, no. Is that motorcycle place?
It is. Yeah. Mm. When we first moved here... Miranda and I were working at Pi. A regular came in and told us about it. And it was like, oh, it's this side of, like, it's a pretty secret California thing. Like, you gotta drive up the road.
Pretty secret.
This was 5.5 years ago. And so the first time we went, there was nobody there. Like, we didn't wait in line, we talked to them, had, like, a nice sit-down thing, and it got a little busier. But it was like, okay, this is a normal restaurant. Every single time I've gone after, that line has gotten bigger and longer. And, like, now there's a rope that you have to stand around, and it, like, leads you around. Yeah, like, it's nuts. It's like waiting for a ride at Disney.
Wow. I didn't have a line when I went, but it was not a secret. There was definitely a lot of people there.
Yeah, I got stung by a bee on beach day. And, like, I still have a thing from it. And so we were going into Neptune's Net, and I was like, I don't feel good, and my shoulder really hurts. Maybe it's... Oh, yeah, it's right there. I have, like, the stinger or something is still in there.
Oh, really?
Something's in there. Because what happened, Dan had his backpack, and apparently there was a bee on the backpack, and I swung it over my shoulder, and he went to the bathroom, and I handed it back to him, and I was like, wait, and, like, flicked it off. And so I think, had I not slammed the backpack onto my shoulder and accidentally killed the bee, it would have fully stung me, but...
Oh.
Yeah. And it was like a wasp. It was huge. So, I feel bad for the bee. Good for me. But we had to get the big, like, 40-ouncer beer to, like... So I just sat like this the entire time. But yeah, they have great fish.
I'm not envious of you. What did we miss here? Give her our best and let her know I'll read for her. I will. Thank you, Hefton. It's really nice of you to say. Prometheus, 4Q. I'm not even going to click on that. I'm not going to click on that. I told you. No. The one where Jess raps about fish. You are so rude.
Are all of our things getting titled the one where, like, we're friends now?
That is very, very rude, and I'm not gonna even acknowledge it beyond right now. We should send her some convalescence whiskey. Oh, she would like that.
Did she finish her first bottle of whiskey? Didn't she get a bottle? What am I thinking of? Oh, never mind.
I think you're thinking of my whiskey. Yeah. I have a huge thing of whiskey. I'm gonna need downloadable audio for that joke! If you want to stay friends with me, you don't encourage that behavior.
That's the idea, Lex? What's the idea?
I don't know. Whiskey?
All the time?
Lexi's a tough mutter, though. I believe in her.
I did not believe in me when that happened.
She's not really a tough mutter, though, because she didn't get to go.
That's true. I never competed. So there are a lot of tough mutters that would be very angry. Ooh.
What?
I like this color better.
How come that one's blue and the other one's purple?
I didn't add as much of the vodka in.
Oh.
Just because I'm...
Oh, the new title scheme. That's the idea. The one.
Oh, gotcha.
You look fab. Love the look. Thank you. Did you... miss the explanation of who our wizards are? Because that's what we're going for.
Yeah. We're smarty pants.
Mm-hmm.
We're book smart. We're so smart.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
These blueberries are delicious.
I'm enjoying this a lot.
If I start getting a little loopy, it's because I ate too many vodka-infused blueberries.
They're very sweet. Very sweet indeed. Mmm.
But like, I could eat these for days because you're the sweetness of the blueberry. And it gets all over your hands.
If I could have but one wish, it would be to have this fish dish forever in my mouth to enjoy it. From here on out, it's the fish wish dish and the cone of cold martini here on damsels and dishes. And we're glad you're here to enjoy it.
Ba-da-da-da-dum. Half Donut, why a fighter first? Have we done a fighter episode?
No, we have not done a fighter episode because I have never made a fighter.
I have.
Hmm.
Also, Punzi's a fighter.
Is she? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Fighters are good. They're a good, like...
They're fun.
They're one of the easier classes, I guess, mm-hmm. but I don't know if any class is really that easy.
No, I definitely think they're one of the easiest classes I've ever played.
Hmm. It is definitely like I feel like barbarians are very easy too.
Yeah. I feel like fighters you can do a little bit more. Because your choices are there.
Because you have the
eating blueberries out of the gut.
The martial fighting types or whatever.
Yeah. Or like, can't you dual wield like right off the bat?
Hmm. I just jumped at you and you built a character sheet. Hey, that's a perfect way to pick it.
Yeah.
The class. That's wonderful. Yeah.
There was no judgment. I was literally just curious.
Yeah. What is Patrick? Oh, he's a paladin.
I haven't played with him yet.
That's what he is. Patrick is amazing. He's so good. He's so funny. I mean, he's Wesley's boyfriend, so she's hilarious.
Oh, I met the two of them together.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
They're so funny. So funny. And I might have spent about 3 months binging the Spartacus seasons from Stars.
Oh, that'll be nice, too, because if we don't have... I don't have to work the next day.
Mm.
I'm not going to be stressing about it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll drink, and then I'll walk home. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. And most likely, the next session will be... Well...
Don't say the last one.
No.
Okay.
No. We'll either be continuing the adventure by encountering the next... challenge,
yes.
Or the NPCs gave you like 1,000 side quests.
Oh, sweet.
So you can do a side quest too.
Yay! All of my other D&D games are done, so like, it's my only one now.
Me too, for a little bit, until my Wednesday resumes. And your secret was not revealed. We didn't even meet the person who might reveal it. So, that's good.
I forgot what my secret
is. I gave him a secret. Your faction.
Oh, yeah. That I belong, don't belong, belong to.
Uh-huh.
I need to find my character sheet.
Dixon Fall, Fernal. Hi! Welcome
Hey-o.
To Damsels and Dishes. Well, you should find that. Level 2.
Mm-hmm.
Level 2.
I thought I left it at your house, but I was like, she hasn't said I left it there, so I must have it.
I don't really look, though, when I pack up. So, I can look.
Just a quick glance.
Yeah.
I was probably...
I just kind of, like, plop it all in there.
Well, I think I was a dum-dum and left it in a book.
Mmm. Oh! There were papers in Elena's book.
Cool. Hopefully she didn't look at those because my faction or my thing's in there.
I don't think she would.
But also, like, her character and my character are friends, so if anyone would know, she would know.
The one with the damsel's anthem. See, that one I'm a little more okay with.
See, that one I'm a little more scared with.
Fish wrap is not something I ever want to be associated with.
Dat fish wrap, though. Why do I want to be associated with fish wrap?
You should already have immunity if you're a sub. Yeah, I don't know. Huh. Maybe because Dix is kind of like Maybe that's a pretty common way of trying to get around an auto-moderator, so it's like,
no!
We're gonna need to triple-check that. Because I think sexual things are worse than saying swear words, you know?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thoroughly enjoying everything that happened tonight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna eat the blueberries, too. Get out of there! Get out of the candle holder part! You're not a candle anymore!
So, Dan was joking around, because I went to JPL this weekend. That was really fun.
What's JPL?
JPL is the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, and once a year, they have an open house.
Get it?
They have an open house where you get to go in, and you get to see all the space stuff, and the Earth science stuff. And so, basically, JPL works with NASA. Well, JPL, NASA, APL. And so they do all of these really cool things that I never knew about. Like, I thought I was going to go see Voyager and, like, the rover and a bunch of stuff like that. But I learned so much. I learned so much science, and I feel like such a cool nerd now.
Yay!
Like, they have... So, apparently... I'm trying to explain this quickly and, like, making it all make sense. But so, they have these different divisions, and they have an Earth Science division, where there's a person who... has, like, monitors, like, their entire thing is just to monitor movement, and they have earthquake sensors, so, like, they want to be able to predict that kind of stuff, and the obvious things. But the cool one that I thought was awesome is that our drinking water, where does it come from?
The LA River?
Our drinking water comes from Colorado in the mountains. So what happens is there's this giant tube, and when the snow melts, it goes into this reservoir and runs off, and that's how we get our drinking water.
No way. Even in LA?
Yeah, well, specifically LA, because we have no water. Like, we have literally no water. We watched this video about Earth science, and I was like, these are all really scary problems!
You know, you could make an Earth Genasi wizard and have them focus on Earth
Captain
science.
Captain Planet.
Yeah. Have them be like a total hippie.
Yeah. That would be fun.
That would be fun!
But yeah, so this guy, his entire purpose in JPL is like his Earth Science team that he heads up is to find a better source of drinking water. And so they went to go see what the problem was because our sources had been drying up over the last couple of years. We're like, we have this crisis of water. Oh, we found it by taking the mountain, like the water from Colorado. That's starting to dry up. Now what do we do? And it was like, before we panic, let's go see what the problem is. So his team went up there, and everything was kind of gray. He's like, that doesn't make sense. So, like, it's a bunch of snow. Like, snow above your head. And so he scraped away at it, and you could see, like, this beautiful white snow beneath it. And he was like, oh, weird. It's dust. Layers of dust going over the snow from, like, life in general and pollution and all that stuff. And weirdly enough, ATV vehicles in the area kick up dust really bad. So they like kept hiking and going around and checking out other things, and they came back 6 or 8 hours later and the snow had melted this much. And how they knew is because the cover that he had, like the chunk of it that he had uncovered, was unmelted.
Why is that? Global warming? Climate change?
Well, the dust is dark, and dark colors attract heat. So the part that he had scraped away, which is why snow stays pretty and stays bigger when it's colder, is like, it's cold, but it's also reflecting sunlight. And so because of all the pollution and dust that had been kicked in, the snow was melting faster because it was covered with a dark source. So it was like, huh, there's not really a way to solve that, but that's cool that you found that out.
Wow.
So yeah, now they're trying to find a way to,
get rid of the dust.
Yeah.
Wow. There's so much I don't know about climate change. Oh, good night, TC Lesser. Thank you for joining us.
Good night. Thank you. But yeah, I learned so much.
That's really interesting. Can you just go for free?
Yeah, it's free every year. It only happens once a year. And so it's Saturday and Sunday, and you have to sign up for your tickets in advance. I want
to
go both days next year because I don't think anybody understands how big JPL is. And it was... like, you have to stand in line for an hour to see some of these things. It was nuts how many people were there.
That's not appealing to me.
But they have, like, food and really pretty picnic areas, and when you're standing in line with your friends, that hour ticks by really quick, where I was like, the information I'm receiving and how educated I feel, like, it was worth it.
Yeah, worth the wait.
Yeah. So it was awesome. Like, you got to go in Mission Control. They call it the center of the universe because they literally monitor every satellite and stuff. So
that's
like,
awesome.
Yeah, it's the one day out of the year that you get to do that.
Prometheus says, I want to visit JPL one day.
It's awesome.
I read a debate years ago, and someone in California was like, let's just cut the water off. And totally, depriving people of one of the most essential things to live and letting them all die. What? Why would someone do that? I mean, I guess anything is possible in today's political climate, but who knows? We shan't get into that.
Right.
Oh, that was kidding? What? Oh, I'm gonna stand in line for an hour. There's about to be a kid in a mouse costume again.
What? like a Mickey Mouse or a Chuck E. Cheese? Those are very different
important
outings.
But I think we're pretty much wrapped up here with the food, yeah?
Yeah.
We talked about our wizards, how we feel about them.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm excited to play Vahima in the future. And I hope you get to play Adina as well.
Mm-hmm. I have so many characters now. And I think, as much as I was like, I don't want to make a commitment, like, I don't want to join a new D&D game, I think I like what we're doing, where we're kind of, like, fitting it into our schedules, and it's not necessarily a weekly game, but it's all everybody's respecting each other and figuring out when we can go, and yada yada.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like that, where I was like, I don't want it to end. I don't want it to be, like... Because originally, you were like, it'll be, like, a four...
I know. I need to revise that, because we have just barely dipped our toes in. And we're only two sessions in.
It's because we're funny. And we are really supportive of each other.
This campaign, I thought, was a lot shorter. Lost Mine and Phandelver. It could take...
years.
At this rate, it could take an entire year to cover.
Yes!
At the rate we're doing, where it's every couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Not consistently. If we were to play consistently, I think we could finish it in a few months.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. We'll have to see where the future goes, but I don't know. I'm still figuring out how to DM, so I don't want to commit to a full campaign, which works for everybody, luckily, at this time.
Yeah.
Did you cover what your favorite thing is about wizards? My favorite thing about wizards is I like to creative problem solve. And I think that's the name of the game with wizards. We kind of discussed how the difference between wizards and sorcerers is that sorcerers can use meta magic to be creative with their spells. Wizards just have a lot of spell slots. So they're going to be able to spend their spell slots on things like Alarm and Featherfall. You know, No other class is going to be like, I need to make sure I prepare Featherfall just in case. Because it's like, when is that ever going to happen? But a wizard's like, pew, pew, pew. I got it in my book. Pew, pew, pew.
I got it in my book.
And warlocks are cool because I think thematically they're just cool for flavor. But mechanically, wizards are the supreme spellcasters. And
overall?
Just based on how many spells you get, how many you can learn, how many you can have. Yeah, I think so.
Huh.
Over sorcerers.
Okay. I was like, because you think they are over druids?
Oh, for sure, because druids aren't full casters.
Yeah, but you...
Are they? Actually, druids might be full casters.
Yeah, they're full casters.
But they also are fighters.
Mm-mm. They're not fighters, they're full casters.
But they fight as animals.
That's only a certain thing.
Only the moon?
I think so, yeah. I have to double check on that, because I was 100% convinced it was only the moon.
Oh. No, I mean, you can turn into animals with any other class, it's just that moon gives you more.
More, yeah.
And sooner. Are druids full... real?
Are druids real?
Okay, that's not... Who are 5e full casters? I'm curious. I'm very curious.
Yeah, wizard, cleric, druid are full casters.
No, cleric is definitely not a full caster. That's not right. Cleric is not.
Sorcerer. Oh, they're complaining that...
Half versus full casters. But this is all anecdotal, so who knows? It looks like they are talking about the same thing in here. Okay. So, purely mechanical distinction. Ah.
Half-casters are paladins and...
Rangers.
Rangers.
Yeah.
But yeah, a druid is a full-caster.
Oh, okay. So...
You know what's really cool? When they get up into higher levels, they can use spells as their animals.
Spells as their animals?
Mm-hmm. You can spell cast in Wild Chick.
Oh.
So you can be like, I'm a bear and I'm gonna blow you up.
I would still say wizards would be more powerful purely magic-wise, in my opinion, because wizards, instead of getting the cool stuff that druids get, they just get more magic.
If we're going on spell slots alone, then yes.
Well, I'd say access to spells.
No, because as a druid, you have access to everything. You just swap it out.
But wizards get more in their book. You get six to start, and you get more and more every level. And then you can prepare a number of those, and then you have a number of spell slots. What does the audience think? Druids versus wizards!
I feel like, in a way, they're kind of a tie. Just because... there's more of a balance and there's more power, where even...
Like druids and sorcerers are a tie.
No, druids are way more powerful than sorcerers.
Eh? I disagree.
Mm-mm.
I disagree!
You're allowed to!
Oh my gosh! Okay, hold up. Hold up. We gotta look up some stuff here. Okay. Hold on.
Oh.
Actually not in there. We're gonna actually pull up the book. We got the book. We got the book in digital form. We're gonna pull it up. We're gonna take a look. Come here.
What are we taking a look at? What are you basing this decision off of?
I'm gonna show you.
Okay. It says in the book?
No. I'm gonna look at the stuff you get. Okay, so druid. Oops. Druids get...
But are you looking at number, or are you looking at power of spell?
Well, the spells are all... the level of them?
Well, like, because some spells are way more powerful than other spells.
Well, yeah, but...
Especially, like, druids early on. Like, their spells don't seem really great, but as they grow, their spells get more and more and more powerful. Where, like, they can take out hordes of people in one fell swoop.
But there aren't many spells that druids have that wizards don't have access to.
You're talking about a sorcerer.
Or sorcerer. Sorcerer... Yeah, I wonder what the difference is between sorcerers and druids.
Well, because I'm saying druids are definitely stronger than sorcerers.
I disagree! Okay, so 6th level, we'll just go off of... Okay, 7th level, you start getting 4th level spells. 1, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3.
Well, right, and it would depend on... Like, you can't just pull power in. Like... Because sorcerers can't heal.
No, it might be different. It might be different. 3, 3, 4, 7. Yeah, so it's... Wait, hold on. What did I say, 7th level? Oh, it's the same.
Yeah.
It's the same.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, yeah, I would agree then. Druids are probably more powerful than sorcerers. Because of the versatility that you have with turning into animals. Metamagic is good.
It's not good,
but
controlling.
It's only as good as the player is.
Right.
Because some people don't even use it.
Right.
And that goes along with my whole thing. When people, like, play classes and then they save stuff, like, you're a barbarian, but you save your rages, like, what are you saving them for? You have 4 of them. I know you suffer exhaustion when you go into a frenzy rage, but just use it, man. What are you waiting for?
Oh, that was Jess at a table when I was like, I only have one wild shape left. And you were like, oh, I don't care.
What are you saving it for?
In case I run out of spell slots. Or in case my health gets really bad.
But then the game gets fun.
Right. I definitely feel that I started playing and wanted to save stuff, and I felt like I was important because we didn't have a lot of healers early on.
Wizard has the same amount of spell slots as Sorcerer and
Told you.
But mechanically, they get access to significantly more spells, for sure. Because that's like the only thing they get. They don't get Wild Shape, they don't get Mana Magic, they just get a ton of spells. Because they start with 6, and then they get 2 more every level. And sorcerers don't get very many at all.
No, they don't.
They get very few, but then they're always prepared. So.
Druids do get a lot of spells, though. Yeah. Not as many as a wizard, but. Hmm. And I also think it does depend on the spell.
You know what?
Like, you can't heal, so you're not as versatile.
Sorcerers?
Wizards.
Well, wizards can pick up a healing spell. Healing word or, you know, whatever.
Yeah. But, like...
But they can't heal innately.
Yeah.
But druids have to pick up those, too.
Yeah. My brain's thinking.
Paladins. You know what we should do? We should start a new Twitch series. Bards are the most powerful class. Wrong.
Mm-mm.
However... How can you argue with Scanlan? We should start a new series where we have a debate style where, for example, Lexi has a personal attachment to druids. Jessica has a personal attachment to sorcerers. We sit down, we go, all right, crack open the books. Who is more powerful? Or who is a better healer? Or who is all this stuff? And we debate with each other. And we see,
yes, let's do it!
Yeah! Throw a bard in there. And you know what? Sometimes we can mix the classes up, you know? We can do barbarian versus wizard. And it's like, you know what? Who really is more powerful? I don't know. This one's harder to play, but this one actually gets stuff done. I don't know.
Or it's like,
gonna save you when times are dire.
Which one's more versatile? Which one's more necessary in this situation?
Which one you gonna want when you face a baby red dragon?
Huh? Which one you wanna want? When the undead come back.
I would totally watch that. Maybe we could debate for a while and then do Battle Royale type. I think this is a novel idea.
And that would be a lot of work.
Because Lexi and I have already talked about alignment. Oh, we could have a debate over alignment too.
Robin Hood!
Is alignment good or is he not good? Yeah, Robin Hood's alignment. Yeah, what did we argue about? What was it?
I said he was chaotic good and you said he was lawful good? Or...
No, you said he was lawful good. Because he followed his own law.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I still stand by that even though I just forgot.
I want to see a debate on that.
That's the show I want to see a debate on. Is Oh, hey, thanks, Steve!
Yay! Thank you for the subscription, Steve!
Ow!
Barbarian versus Wizards. Who is better at selling real estate in Waterdeep?
Awesome.
I mean...
That would be so great. And, like, you guys send us in suggestions, and then we pick one. And that's what we debate.
And they should be specific. Not, like, who is better, but it should be, like, who is better at something specific.
And if we think they're, like, silly and we couldn't have a long debate on them, we'd do, like, 2 during a show or something.
Yeah, yeah. That would be... It can be a podcast.
Gentles and debates! Ooh! It could be a podcast!
Oh, my God. Our brand is growing. It could totally be a podcast.
Gentles and debates.
We have to, like... If this is a real thing, hypothetically, we'd have to, like, study the books.
Oh, yeah, you'd also kick my butt every time.
Not necessarily.
I don't know, you know the book way better than I do, where I'd have to be like, oh my god, hang on.
We would study the book, and then, because we'd want, like, weirdly specific questions that we can't prepare for, you know? Who is better with healing spells?
Druids. I'm just gonna say druids every time.
But clerics, though. Clerics are, like, supreme healers. And bards can heal, too.
Healing... Wait. Healing... Touch? Where you have to touch them? Or, like, you have to heal them from far away? See, you gotta get
that would be part of the debate. It'd be like, well, you know what? I have access to this spell, and I can do it from far away. And then you throw in a curveball, like, well, are we including feats, like magic initiate? Because Adele was a warlock, and she could heal.
Right.
But that's only because she picked up a feat. Does that count?
No, I think we'd have to have... No, I think we'd have to do, like, straight rules, where... Well, because then you don't want to have to be like, well, I made him a dual wielder. Like, why wouldn't that matter?
D&D debates. We can't publish this video. We can't publish this on YouTube. Someone's going to steal this idea.
Yeah, we can't.
Someone's going to steal our idea and monetize it and take it from us.
Oh, man, and we could monetize it because we wouldn't have to worry about anything!
Yeah! Advertisers would totally want to advertise on our show.
Two girls talking about D&D, duking it out.
We could work some logistics out on this end, questions, topics, etc. It's tempting. It's tempting. I mean, we got the mic.
We'll discuss.
It just takes so much. Oh, shut up, Prometheus.
It's so much work to start another series. I think a podcast would be more achievable.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, we could film it, but it would literally be Jess and I sitting at a table. There wouldn't be a lot of production value.
That's when you would need, like, geek names. You know, people you want to watch, like Becca Scott versus Ivan, things like that.
No, this is how we make ourselves names. Widow by widow, the damsels take over.
We would have to do so much research.
I know, but like, it kind of sounds fun.
Like,
I'm gonna order my book.
We could have someone. You should. You should. Maybe get it secondhand or something, like Craigslist.
I know, I want it to be mine.
Yeah. Because there's also, like, people take tweets from Jeremy Crawford and Mike Merles as, like, canon. So if they clarify something on their Twitter, then they're like, oh, okay, then that's what that is in the book. Like, that's what it's supposed to mean, because it's a little unclear. It's a little muddy. So, like, we'd have to know that, too. We'd be like, Mike Merles said, Jeremy Crawford said this on Twitter in January.
Oh, and we'd have to have certain rules where, like, it wouldn't be, like, sitting in front of a PC. No, we'd have to have, like, our books and then agree to, like, now we consult the internet where all you can use is the book.
So if we had this, like, who's the better spellcaster debate, which we wouldn't because it's too broad, but we'd have to be, like, because your idea, my idea was first spell slots.
Right.
Which I got schooled on because when we look in the book, they have the same amount of spell slots. So then we would go into
types
of spells. Were like types of spells. Like druids get like huge AoE spells where they can take down a lot of enemies. And then I would go into like, so you would have to look that up in the book.
Right.
I would go into how many spells a wizard can prepare versus how many spells a druid can prepare. And like, is that better than having, or do I get access to the spells that druids get access to that she thinks are so powerful? If I don't, do my additional spell slots really, are they more powerful than having those good spells?
Oh, and we need the, like, it'd be really fun to have the spell cards and then we can, like, play war with them and be like, no, this is more powerful.
Man, doing the fighters, though, would be hard. Doing classes that we haven't played would be harder, though. Like,
but at this point,
doing a fighter,
we've created characters in most of them.
Yeah. I won't speak for anyone else, but if you really want to do this, I'd be willing to do what I can. Thank you, Half Donut. That's really nice of you to offer.
But yeah, we'll have to talk about it.
Green screen production where it's like, you project the question, and then, green screens are so hard though. You have to have like a legit studio.
Also, I'm blonde.
Yeah, which
like,
is an
I'm
issue.
A big pain in the butt in front of a green screen. Like, you don't, we tried to do that once, didn't we? Where like, my hair
with
just,
The Sims.
Yeah.
Yeah, it just didn't work.
But yeah.
Wow! Alright, writing this down somewhere. This is a good idea. But I'm in. Always. Alright.
Yeah, now we gotta go, because we gotta go talk about this.
It's time to go, y'all. Thank you for joining us. Next week, I think...
Ooh, Incredibles!
It's the Incredibles.
Yes!
Let me double check.
No, it's the Incredibles, because it comes out the 15th.
Yeah?
I would bet... kitten on
what you gonna bet? A kitten?
Yeah.
Ain't nobody got a kitten to be betting.
All right.
Weird Al.
The Incredibles!
Yes!
And then we got the Oregon Trail, which we're going to have to figure out how to get.
Oh, yeah.
And then...
Oh, we just did Wizards, so we're going to have to... Oh, maybe we can finally get the beer together.
Yeah.
Me and Dawash.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool. We've got some good stuff coming up.
We do. The perfect excuse for Lexi to have a new hat each week. Just awesome. As Violet?
Yeah, you'd have to be Violet.
Yeah, I guess I would be. Who's blonde? The dad. The baby!
I get the baby!
Lexi is Jack. And I can just talk like this the whole time.
And then they'll just like...
Jack, stop.
I'll just run circles around you. Blonde. Also, I think Dash is blonde.
Yeah.
Just run around you a lot.
All right, guys. Thank you for joining us. And we will see you next week at 8 p.m.
with the Incredibles.
Yay. Okay.
Honey, bye. Where is my super suit?